Let's work through the following problems together. The directions state, if applicable, use symmetry to calculate the integrals. So we just learned that knowing if a function is even or odd can help us simplify taking certain definite integrals. Specifically, if we're taking a definite integral from negative a to a, and the function is even or odd, then we can simplify the process a bit. So let's go through a few examples of that. So the first example is the integral from negative 1/2 to 1/2 of x to the 11th dx. So the fact that this is a symmetric bounds, right, we have the form negative a to a, should clue us in that perhaps symmetry might be a way to simplify this integral. So then, what I need to do is I need to check and see if x to the 11th is an even function or an odd function, or maybe neither, in which case I wouldn't be able to simplify it. So to check if something is even or odd, we look at what f of negative x is. Okay, and if f of negative x equals f of x, then it's even. If f of negative x is negative f of x, then it's odd, or it can also be neither. Okay, so here we have f of x equals x to the 11th. So f of negative x is going to be negative x to the 11th. Now, if I take something negative and raise it to an odd power, it remains negative. So, for example, like if I did negative 2 to the third power, that would be negative 8, right? 2 to the third is 8, and then but the negative stays because it's an odd power. So same thing here. So this is going to be negative x to the 11th, which is negative f of x. So what we just determined is that f of x is odd in this case. So then, if you remember what an odd function looks like, now this isn't x to the 11th that I'm drawing here, but an odd function is going to look something like maybe this. Okay, where it's symmetric about the origin. So if you take the integral over a symmetric boundary about 0, then the integral is going to be 0, right? Because you can think of the two sides kind of canceling each other out. One's above the axis and one's below the axis, but they have the same area. So then the net area is 0. So what the rule officially says is this. Okay, so if you're taking the integral from negative a to a of f of x, and f is odd, then this is 0. So in this our case, this is just 0. Okay, so let's look at another example. All right, so same deal here. We have symmetric bounds, right, negative 2 to 2. So we'd like to see if our function here is even or odd. And that will tell us if we can use any of these simplifying rules. So let's check it. Let's evaluate f of negative x. So if I plug in negative x, I've got negative x to the 8th minus 2 times negative x squared plus 3. Okay, so this gives me 3x to the 8th minus 2x squared plus 3. Now, does that simplify to f of x? Well, yeah, it does, right? Because f of x was 3x to the 8th minus 2x squared plus 3. So we've shown that f of negative x equals f of x. So then this is an even function. And what do we know about the integral of an even function? So for integrating an even function, okay, so if f is even and we're integrating from negative a to a, then this is 2 times the integral from 0 to a of f of x dx. So once again, if I just were to draw you a quick picture, maybe an even function looks something like this. It's symmetric with respect to the y-axis. So if I'm trying to find this whole area here, I can just find the area on one side of the y-axis and multiply by 2 because of the symmetry. So that's what I'm going to do here. So let me actually make a little more room. Okay, so what we're saying is this is 2 times the integral from 0 to a of 3x to the 8th minus 2x squared plus 3. So if I quickly take this antiderivative, okay, I'm going to leave that 2 out front. I'm going to take the antiderivative, so that's going to be 3x to the 9th over 9 minus 2x cubed over 3 plus 3x, and I'm going from 0 to 2. All right, this should be a 2 up here. All right, so let's see if we can plug this in. So we've got 2, 3 times 2 to the 9th over 9 minus 2 cubed over 3 plus 3 times 2. Okay, that was plugging in 2, right? Okay, let me add an extra layer of parentheses here. Now, I need to plug in 0 and subtract that, right? So if you just glance at this, if I plug in 0, every term is going to give me 0. So that's kind of the nice thing about simplifying it like this, because 0 is often really easy to plug in. All right, so as your final answer, I'm not going to actually finish calculating this out, but you would just take all these fractions, right, and plug them into your calculator and subtract and add and multiply by 2, and you should get your final numeric answer. So there's one more problem that I wanted to look at really quick, and it looked like this. I just want to point out that you need to be really careful, right? X squared is symmetric, right? That's a really friendly even function, right? That's a parabola. It's symmetric about the y-axis. But look at my bounds, negative 1 to 2, right? The bounds have to be symmetric in order to use these simplifying tricks. So to calculate this integral, I would not be able to use any of the simplifying tricks. I would just integrate it normally, okay? So this is how you use even and odd symmetry to simplify taking integrals.